Boar's Head is bringing a slice of Japan to the deli. Introducing Boar's Head Ichiban Teriyaki Style Chicken. Tender, slow-roasted chicken breast, coated in our signature teriyaki glaze, where ginger, garlic, and a hint of brown sugar meet for a flavor that's both sweet and savory. New Boar's Head Ichiban Teriyaki Style Chicken. The bold flavor of Japan. Now at the deli. Only from Boar's Head. Compromise elsewhere.
Blog Talk Radio.
This is True Capitalist Radio.
True Capitalist Radio.
I am your host, the man they call Ghost.
The badass of business.
Give him capitalism or give him death.
That's it. Period.
Broadcasting from his Skylight Office Studios in beautiful downtown Austin, Texas.
You sound fruitier than a box of Fruit Loops, for Christ's sake.
And now, he'll take it from here. Your host, the prognosticator of prognosticators, the man they call
Ghost.
Out here, folks, for any investor that's invested in the equities markets, you know as well as I, the investors are continuing to sell off, and if you have any kind of vested interest in energy or oil, you reaped in major profits today because that's where the investors were going, not to mention the metals market. Of course, there was a sell-off on copper. We're going to talk about all that in a minute, folks. I want to thank everybody for tuning in live with me in the broadcast. I am your host, the man they call Ghost. And once again, folks, I want to thank everybody for tuning in with me. If you could please retweet the program, put it on your social networking sites, spread the word at this point in time. If you're tuning in live, the website to direct them is blogtalkradio.com/ghost. That's blogtalkradio.com/ghost. A lot of things happening, folks. A lot of things to talk about. This is episode number 29 for the individuals that are keeping track with the True Capitalist program. So many things to go over, so many things to talk about, and let me tell you, it's been a shaky day, to say the least, when it comes to the equities markets out here in the U.S. equities markets. It's been kind of queasy, to say the least. The investors are reacting to the destabilization in the Middle East. We're seeing a lot of reactionary sell-offs. Individuals are selling off all the gains that we've had thus far. As I've said in the past True Capitalist broadcast, I have told investors to be apprehensive at all the gains that we were having on a consistent basis. And, this is exactly what I had prognosticated. You can look back in the archive if you don't believe me. blogtalkradio.com/ghost. Look back in the beginning of the True Capitalist radio show, I predicted that the gains that the markets were continuously having were going to retract at some point based upon a lot of factors. And we talked about how most companies have been chopping their bottom lines. They've been laying off people. They've been cutting pensions. They've been doing a lot of cutting, to say the least. And by the time fourth quarter fiscal year 2010 came around, they were able to profit considerably because we all know that everybody spends money on the holiday season, and that's basically what has fueled a lot of these gains is a bunch of inflated earnings, as you can see here, folks. But as I've said, a retraction was coming, and a retraction did happen. A retraction did happen, for Christ's sake, folks. And let me tell you, if you happen to have any kind of interest in the equities market, there was a mass sell-off. A mass freaking sell-off, for Christ's sake. Once again, we had another triple-digit loss in the Dow Jones Industrial. The Dow Jones Industrial lost 107.01 points, basically closing out at 12,105.80, a change of minus 0.88% in the Dow Jones Industrial. That was a very considerable loss, a lot of sell-offs. You can tell that investors are apprehensive, they're helter-skelter, they're skittish, to say the least. S&P 500 also took a bad dip, to say the least. It was down 8.04 points, a change of minus 0.61%, closing out at 1,307.40. NASDAQ minus 33.43 points, a change of 1.21%. NASDAQ closing out at 2,722.99. Very interesting couple of days in the equities markets, folks. It's been very sickening, to say the least, to anybody who's actually invested in the equities market. But if you're a diversified individual, like Ghost is always preaching, baby, Ghost is always preaching diversification. Now, I know that I haven't been getting into, you know, the whole futures trading, options trading, that sort of thing, because I think that it's rather difficult and it's rather complicated to explain. The gains are lucrative, but you actually have to develop a strategy. And the best way to develop an investment strategy is to invest in equities and understand how to buy low, sell high, based upon all indicators that affect that sector that you're invested in. But I was trading oil futures this morning. I was trading Dow Jones Industrial futures this morning. I woke up at about 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning in Austin, Texas time, and I was trading futures because when I turned on the television, said turn on the tickers on the computer, I saw that people were actually investing in futures on the positive side. I mean, I don't know if you folks were awake at that point in time investing, but Dow Jones Industrial Futures went as high as like 60 points. 60 points in the futures market. And I knew for a fact that we were not going to close on the plus side. So, you know, that's basically what you do when you buy futures in, you know, whatever market, whether it's S&P, whether it's Dow Jones, whether it's NASDAQ. When you buy futures, you're basically betting on the fact whether or not the market is going to close on the positive side or the negative side. And for some reason, a lot of bozos out here actually believe early in the morning trading, early in the futures market, they actually believed we're going to close out on the plus side today based on what? I have no idea. No freaking idea whatsoever. So anyway, what happens is I am obviously betting on the negative side of the market. I bought some considerable futures. Don't want to get into the whole details of the matter. But the bottom line is even though my equities were down in my portfolio, I have diversified, not to mention trading futures, but I've invested in gold. I've invested in silver. You know, I'm a commodities trader also, folks. I mean, that's why I'm always emphasizing commodities when I do the rundown about the markets. I mean, you have to know where the money's at. Diversification is key. Even when equities markets are down, you have to know where to put your money in. And I don't want to get into the whole future setup, folks, but I made some serious cake because everybody in the morning, if you were up this morning, you know what I'm talking about. The futures market were up in the Dow Jones Industrials. I saw it up as high as 60 points, you know? 60 points, for Christ's sake. And I knew for a fact, an absolute fact, that it wasn't going to close on the plus side. And I made some serious capital on that. Made some serious capital on my gold investments, silver investments. I've been day trading ETFs of oil and energy all day, not to mention equities and energy. I mean, have you seen the gas companies? They've been going through the roof, volatility everywhere. So if you're actually day trading, you can kind of scrape some capital off of day trading, holding shares for, you know, maybe, 5, 10, 15, 30 minutes, an hour, depending on where you think the bottom's going to be at in the volatility throughout the day's chart. So anyway, folks, there was a lot of opportunities, and yet, if you're just putting all your eggs in one shell there, and what I mean by putting all your eggs in one shell is putting all your eggs in the equities markets, you've got to diversify. That's why I know there's people out here that email me up saying, man, Ghost, why are you telling me to go to the damn pawn shop, baby, and buy gold? Why are you telling me to do that, man? I don't do that thing, man. Well, this is exactly why. All right, and let's go ahead and get to the commodities, shall we, since we already went over the markets. Commodities, let's go ahead and talk about them for a second. Gold today alone, it's been spiking ever since after President's Day. But let's just go right to gold. I know that we usually talk about other commodities before this, but gold is up $11.20. It's closed over $1,400 an ounce. Right now it is $1,412.30 an ounce of gold. That's right. I continue to in my speculations, I think that we're going to continue to see a rise in that on a variety of different factors. I've talked about them on my blog. You can get to my blog at ghostpolitics.blogspot.com. That's ghostpolitics.blogspot.com. But I continue to see nothing but bullish activity happening in the metals market, gold and silver. Silver today up 65 cents, closing out at about 33.51. And I continue to see uprises in both of those metals. We saw a sell-off in the copper's market. It was down $3.45, but you know, basically everybody there is cashing in their gains and trying to take that capital and put it in somewhere else so they can even get more capital. Do you understand? So it's just unbelievable. And let's just go ahead and go down all the commodities, shall we? Brent crude, folks, if you happen to be trading Brent crude, which is the crude oil that's shipped to Europe and Asia, it is up at unbelievable highs. Today it rose $6.31, a change of 5.97%, closing out at a whopping $112.09 for Brent crude oil. I mean, can you believe this crap? Sweet crude oil, sweet crude, which is what we usually consume in here in America, up $3.46, closing out at 98.88. It actually hit $100 a barrel today. It actually hit $100 a barrel. Unfreaking believable. I'm not joking here, folks. I mean, what did I say time and time again? I had been expecting this spike in crude oil. I mean, it was only a matter of time, for Christ's sake. And if you would have listened to the ghost man, you'd have been making some serious money. That's why I continue to say, and I will always say, that if you listen to True Capitalist Radio, it's like making freaking money. All right? Oil futures are up $33 today. How convenient, huh? Heating oil futures up $12.36. Natural gas, well, you know, since we found out that America is the Saudi Arabia of natural gas, you know, I don't know how much you want to invest in that, but it was up 3 cents. All right, canola futures, they bought in on those sell-offs that we saw yesterday. It was up $16.40, a change of 2.91%. And let me tell you, we continue and continue and continue to see rises in cocoa futures, folks. Let me tell you, chocolate is like gold at this point in time. This Ivory Coast destabilization situation that's happening in Africa. The Ivory Coast, of course, is one of the biggest suppliers of the world's cocoa. And what's unfortunate is we have a political destabilization, and what's new? It seems like that's going around in the world today. Apparently, the people unelected some president out there in the Ivory Coast, and this ass clown just doesn't want to leave. He doesn't want to leave, and it's causing all kinds of unrest and destabilization, and this is why we've seen not just gradual increases in the cocoa futures, but, I mean, just unbelievable gains in the cocoa futures. I strongly challenge you to go to your nearest bakery or go to your nearest chocolatier and take a look at how much chocolates, for Christ's sake, are costed because of this crap. Anyway, they're up $45 today, continuing to rise. Okay? Coffee futures, of course, we were going to see sell-offs on that. We saw gradual rises on that for the past several days. It was down $4.90, a change of 1.79%. Corn futures, we saw a buyback on a lot of those sell-offs that we've seen. It was a dramatic sell-off yesterday. It's up $12 today, a change of 1.74%. Cotton, it's still selling off. I mean, we've seen all-time highs. We were expecting sell-offs. Demand is basically holding itself back. People aren't going out and consuming anymore. So, obviously, cotton futures are not in investors' interest. It's down $3.70 today, a change of 1.97%. Wheat futures are still up. They're not as up as they used to. I mean, we were used to seeing dramatic increases, dramatic gains. We saw sell-off yesterday. They are back up $6.25, a change of 0.71%. Sugar, we're seeing a sell-off on sugar from the gradual increases from there. It's down $1.02, a change of 3.59%. Oat futures are down. We continue to see a sell-off on oats, down $12.50. Wool futures basically just evened out. And cattle futures are up 25 cents. Cattle feeder futures, by time we saw some kind of sell-off off cattle feeder futures, because the damn cattle feeder is worth more than the cattle futures, for Christ's sake. It makes no sense whatsoever, but it's down 20 cents today. We need some more sell-offs on there so we can bring down some of this beef. All right? I mean, give me a damn break. Anyway, that's the markets for you folks. I mean, it's been a, you know, kind of a hectic day. If you happen to have listened to the True Capitalist portfolio and invested in the ETF of OIL, you would have been increasing your portfolio in the midst of the sell-offs in equities. Oil, since I was bullish on it, OIL is the symbol. I was bullish on it February 22nd. You would have got in on it about $23.90. It closed out today up 91 cents. It was actually up $1.50, but there's a lot of people day trading those ETFs. And if you happen to be in or entertaining the day trading market, it's a lot of volatility in these sectors to be able to, rake in some capital, to be able to parlay that in other long-term investments. But oil closed out, or the symbol OIL, the ETF by Barclays, it closed out 26.26. So if you would have listened to the True Capitalist radio program here, you would have increased 9.87% since we were bullish on that ETF, Extended Traded Fund. But let me tell you, the True Capitalist radio portfolio did take a hit. APG, which we were bullish on it on February 18th, you would have got in on it at about 55.85. It closed out today down 25 cents, closing out at a price of 56.86. So we're still up 1.81% on that, but like I said, we're going to continue to see sell-offs, especially on these major stocks that are known throughout the investor community and are just, in a lot of these hedge fund and mutual fund portfolios. You know, these are the idiots that are selling off and are making everybody else's portfolio look like a piece of crap. Coke today was up 2 cents, so since we were bullish on that on February 4th, you would have bought in on it at about 53.16. It is up today 2 cents at a price of 55.04. Cisco today, I mean, good God on Cisco. We were bullish on it February 17th. I'm still bullish on it, as a matter of fact. But we lost a little money on it. It was down 19 cents, at a rate of about 1% down on Cisco. But I'm still bullish on it. It's at a 52-week low at this point. Cisco is one of the staples for fiber optic networking and computing. If you look at the chart on that, I mean, there's no way Cisco is going to stay at that particular price, so I'm long-term on Cisco continuously. Dell Computers sold off today. It was minus 4 cents what was the price on that? 15.11. If you would have listened to us on February 16th, you would have bought in on it at around $14, $14.02. You would have been up 7.77% on your money on that one. GE, oh, good God. You know that major Dow Jones industrial components were going to be sell-offs right away in reaction to the Middle East destabilization. You know this. I know this. So this is why we saw dramatic drops in both GE and GM, and they dropped considerably. GE dropped about 2% in our portfolio, and GM dropped about 3% in our portfolio. But I'm still long-term on both. I just think it's a general sell-off amongst the investors in the community. These are both major Dow Jones industrial components here, so we know that any kind of market reaction is going to affect these stocks. HS, which is symbol HS Health. Hold on, what the hell's the name of this damn Health Spring? I believe Health Spring Inc. It's basically the competitor to APG Amerigroup, which we own also a piece of that. I think there's enough room in that subsidy healthcare market to go around. It closed out today down $1.25, closing out at $36.75. If If you would have listened to us on February 18th, you would have bought in on it at about $34.15. You would have increased 7.61% on your money. Intel taking a considerable dive, a NASDAQ component, and a lot of tech. If you owned any kind of tech stocks in general, you took a dramatic dive. And the reason for tech stocks is because people believe that as the increase in oil happens in the market, it's going to relay itself in the gasoline that people buy in America. And investors and speculators believe that that increase in gasoline price and oil price and energy price is going to affect the pocketbooks of the consumer. And a lot of the consumers aren't going to have enough money to go out and buy electronic widgets and gadgets. But, you know, in my personal opinion, I think that maybe they're being a little bit jumping of the gun at this point in time. I believe that there's still going to be a sell-off in the market. I've been predicting this. We're going to continue to see a sell-off into mid-spring, maybe even going into late spring. But as summertime goes around, we're going to start seeing bottom feeders. We're going to start seeing minor fluctuations in the market. It's going to be good for day traders. And as we move in to the holiday season, the fourth quarter, I think that all these morons are going to save their money so they can get the iPad 2 and the tablets and they can do all these things. I mean, give me a break. It's disgusting. So I believe that this sell-off in the tech sector is just premature, and of course, this is a helter-skelter market. All right, and Xinhuan Real Estate took a dive also, minus 4 points, but we're still up 3.75% on our money. So anyway, that's a true capitalist portfolio, folks, but if you would have listened to Ghost here, all right, if you would have listened to Ghost here, you'd have been ahead of the game and you'd have been either even out or you would have been at least making some profits today in the sell-off in the equities markets. Anyway, that's about all I got to say about that, folks. We're going to talk about other things, but I want to hear from you. 646-652-4869. What the hell are we talking about today? We're talking about obviously, we already talked about the sell-off in the equities markets. Oil hit $100 a barrel today, so I believe that it's going to continue to go up. All this destabilization in the Middle East, even though the Saudi Arabian king has said that he's going to increase production if Libya happens to go under, I just believe that what's unfortunate about this assumption by the market that the Saudi Arabian prince or the Saudi Arabian family is going to be able to supply oil, they have their own destabilization problem. They're trying to suppress what's coming about in Saudi Arabia, folks. Jordan, all these places are having their own unrest. I mean, it's spreading around like wildfire out there, for Christ's sake. And let me tell you, the probability of these unrests that are happening in the Middle East reaching into Saudi Arabia are highly probable. Highly freaking probable, for Christ's sake. And the reason I say that is because, like we were talking about yesterday, this goddamn Egyptian military authority that's taking control of Egypt is allowing Iran to have its military sail through the Suez Canal, which, of course, is going to destabilize a lot of situations. Israel is going to get a little apprehensive, maybe get a little itchy trigger finger. Who the hell knows what the probability of happening is. But let's say the Egyptian situation and the Libyan situation compounds, and it just kind of just makes its way, which it already is in Saudi Arabia, but they're trying to quash it. I don't know if you've read reports today, but the Saudi royal king has promised that he's going to give more money to the people so they can shut their mouths. I don't know if you've read this, but he's like, okay, I know what you're talking about. We'll give you more money, all right? If you have a loan, we will forgive your loan. We will forgive your loan. We will give you unemployment. They're starting to be like America, for Christ's sake. They're getting these idiots entitlements so that they won't go out and revolt against the ruling royal family. But I think at this point in time, what's happening in the Middle East goes beyond the principle of payoffs. It's about the opportunity of being a capitalist. I think that's a lot of what's happening here in the Middle East, and not only that, it's spreading into China, Iran. I think a lot of this wants to basically perpetuate the idea of capitalism, because who doesn't want to be a capitalist? You know? Who doesn't want to be a capitalist, for Christ's sake? I mean, who doesn't want to make serious money? You know, who doesn't want to live lavish? You know, who doesn't want to, you know, do whatever in the hell they want to do, you know? Like me, I'm going to crack open a Negra right now. I've been cracking open Negras since about 1 o'clock because I've made some serious money in the early morning futures markets, because these assholes in the morning actually believed that the Dow Jones Industrial, the NASDAQ, and the S&P were all going to close on the plus side. Of course, yours truly knows better, so I made some money, baby. Yeah! Let me go ahead and open up this this Negra here. That's what I'm talking about. But let me tell you, I think Saudi Arabia should take this uprising serious. They're very totalitarian. They're much like Gaddafi. The only difference is that they're more systematically structured. Gaddafi was just some whacked-out nut job that really is just probably one of the most eccentric and lunatic-based dictators of all time. I mean, maybe in our modern times, I've read about Caligula and, you know, the Roman emperors and a bunch of other people that were probably a little bit more sadistic, but I don't know. You know, I have no idea. Let me go ahead and take a swig of this Negra. Pretty damn good, pretty damn good. But speaking of Muammar Gaddafi, Muammar Gaddafi has announced, basically, you know, I think we broadcasted this yesterday, that he is announcing violence on his own people. And today, according to reports out of Libya, he is fulfilling that promise on violence on his own people. We have reports of his army defecting because they don't want to shoot the people. You know, I mean, Muammar's trying to order bombers to, you know, basically air raid certain cities that have fallen to protesters' hands, you know, have army go out there and start mowing people down in the streets. And a lot of the army in Libya doesn't want to do it, and they're defecting to Malta, Egypt, and other surrounding areas. Well, you know what's up? You know what Gaddafi does? Well, because he's an oil-rich country, and that's what's unfortunate about these Arab countries. That's how come they were able to turn desert holes into modern metropolises, because when you have oil that you can sell on the world market for what is now $100 a barrel, you can make some serious money so you can develop your own goddamn society, and you can bring your own country into modernity, and that's exactly what happened with Gaddafi. Well, he's utilizing the capital that he has to buy African mercenaries, folks, and this is an actual fact. This is actually happening right now in Libya, because Gaddafi wants to stay in power, and the army has defected, the generals have defected. This guy is actually paid African mercenaries from surrounding areas of Africa and has armed them with you know, automatic weapons and put them in planes and tanks and the whole nine yards, and have basically told these African mercenaries to go in and just start killing people out in the streets. And that's exactly what's happening. According to reports, we have over, 2,000 people dead now? There's 2,000. I mean, we don't even know, because they have cut off complete connection with the world. You know, Gaddafi has made sure no communications are getting in and out of Libya, even though the pictures that we're seeing out of there are actually smuggled out of the country or used by other means. But this guy is actually utilizing mercenaries to kill and slaughter his own people. We're having a mass exodus of Libyan people who don't want to participate in any of this stuff. I mean, they just want to live a life and raise a family. These people are defecting now to other parts of the region. Egypt is getting an influx of refugees from Libya. And it's because it's sick, man. I mean, you know, I don't know if you can look online and you can do a search, but you can actually find videos of charred bodies in the street from air raids made by Libyan aircraft. You can see African mercenaries in the street just shooting people, women, children, doesn't matter, whoever's in the streets getting killed. It's a disgraceful event here, and let me tell you, I don't like what Gaddafi's doing, and lest we not forget that this guy this guy right here also has access to biological weapons. And if he gets desperate enough, because the guy's a lunatic. Have you heard his speeches, for Christ's sake? I mean, the guy's a complete and utter kook. Why this guy has power is beyond me, but a lot of people in the State Department, in the Defense Department, and a lot of people in the international community, specifically the UN, are considering that this idiot might just, you know, drop the bomb out here, kill his own people, you know, do a, you know, suicide bomber type of thing, and kind of lay precedent of, well, if Gaddafi used his nukes or used his biological weapons, well, Iran will start doing it on its people. And then, you know, Jordan and, you know, all these other individuals that want to sustain power, they're going to do this sort of thing. I mean, they're going to do it. And let me tell you, this is not setting a good precedent, man. I mean, you know, what the hell's going on here? I mean, you know, just because somebody wants to sustain power is going to gas his own people? This is sick. This is sick here. And let me tell you, the Jasmine Revolution in China isn't quashing itself either. And who the hell knows what the Chinese are going to do to their own people? I mean, this is what's going to happen here. You know, individuals are trapped by their own totalitarian governments out here. And there's nothing they can do. You know, there's nothing they can do about it. That's why we, as individuals in the internet community, have to write blogs. We got to go on forum posts. We got to go into chat rooms. We got to discuss these kinds of issues. Because if we don't talk about these things, these assholes that are mowing people down in the street are going to set a precedent. They're going to set a worldwide precedent on what leaders can do to their people if they get, quote-unquote, into unrest. And it's serious, folks. I mean, you know, I don't know what the hell's happened. This is a new world disorder out here. That's what it looks like. But in my personal opinion, the United States can't just sit back and, you know, think everything's going to be all right here. I mean, you know, I'm not suggesting we need to do anything, but it seems to me that the United States government, not only do they not have any kind of intelligence about what the hell is happening in the Middle East. I mean, we heard Leon Panetta during the Egyptian riots. He didn't even know what the hell was going on. He was, you know, in front of Congress being questioned by some Congress folks, and he actually said, and I quote, well, you know as much as me. I mean, the people know as much as I do, and I think that he's going to write. I mean, this is the head of the CIA. The CIA is supposed to know everything about everybody, and yet they don't know crap about what's happening in Egypt and what the hell's going on in the Middle East. I mean, why are we paying these guys $80 billion a year of taxpayer money for if they're not going to do the freaking job? You know, I mean, it's disgusting, for Christ's sake. But, I mean, we're being, you know, too silent for too long out here. And at some point, if we don't do something out there, I see World War III happening very, very soon. I mean, I'm not trying to be a hyper-sensationalist out here, but there has to be civility. You know, there has to be some kind of civility established in these areas. And if it means taking out a bunch of totalitarian dictators, well, who the hell gives a crap? But we need civility up in here. It's obvious that people don't want to live, you know, under the totalitarian rule, and we just can't watch, you know, humanity just, you know, get mowed down like a bunch of dogs like this. We just can't do this, you know? I mean, I'm serious. We just can't do this anymore, man. I mean, I'm not trying to scare people here, but look at what's happening, all right? It went from Egypt, or went to Tunisia, Tunisia to Egypt, Egypt to Jordan, Jordan to Libya, Libya to, you know, Bahrain, to, you know, the United Arab Emirates, to Morocco, you know, I mean, there's just, it's even hitting China. You know, it's hitting a lot of different places throughout the region over there in the East, folks, and if we don't do anything, if we just stand silent like we did in World War II, who the hell knows what's going to transpire out there? I mean, this is very serious to global civility, you know? And this is why I talk about all these subject matters every single day, folks, because I know they're not going to teach you about this in school, you know? I know they're not going to teach you about this crap in school, folks. They're just going to say, oh, don't worry, everything's going to be okay. Our government's great. They're beautiful. We pay them a lot of money. Let me tell you, there's a lot of chaos going on, and let's not forget that there's other chaos outside of the Middle Eastern chaos. I mean, you've got Pakistan waiting to nuke India. You've got India waiting to nuke Pakistan over the damn Kashmir region. I mean, they've already had two wars that India has won, and let me tell you, the Pakistanis haven't forgotten it. Let's not forget that we've got leftist communists in South America trying to destabilize the emerging markets in that region. You know? Lest we not forget that we've got a bunch of damn European socialist bastards that are sitting here striking and rioting in the street because of the austerity measures. And, of course, folks, we're going to talk about the Greece riots. For all you folks that weren't familiar, back in April of 2010, we had a bunch of Greeks out there on the streets pissing and moaning that they had to go out and go back to work again instead of being a bunch of socialist jerks, sitting there collecting paychecks and, you know, sitting out the Greek sun and retiring at 40 years old and, you know, having five-hour work weeks with three-hour lunches. I mean, they have to go out and work, and they're pissed about it. And let me tell you, they're doing it again. They're rioting again. They're rioting in the streets. I mean, if you look at the Greece riots, there's they're throwing Molotov cocktails at police. I mean, the police aren't mowing these people down like dogs out there in Greece like they are in Libya. You know, they're just trying to baton these people so they can get back in their houses where they belong. But no, you know what these guys are doing? They're Molotov cocktailing the police in the streets because I'm a Greek and I don't want to go back to work. I want the socialism. You know, that's what I want. I want the socialism, and it makes me sick. I mean, look at all the disorder in the world, for Christ's sake. Look at all the disorder in the world, for Christ's sake. I mean, good God. 646-652-4869, folks. I want to take some calls here. What do you think's happening here? I mean, we obviously know how it's affecting the markets. We're having a sell-off in the equities. We have a spike in gold, we have a spike in oil, but, how is it going to affect the world? I mean, we've got a lot of pissed off people all over the globe here, and it's spreading. You know, it's spreading out here. I want to hear from you, 646-652-4869. Let's go ahead and take some calls here. 763, you're on the air.
Hey, how you doing?
What's going on?
Not a lot. I don't know about you, but... I don't use gas, so that doesn't affect me. So I think we should just, bomb the Middle East. We don't need them. They're just causing...
Yeah, you're a stupid idiot. You understand? I mean, that type of little comedy is fun during peacetime. You know, when America, is doing their job and being the guy with the big balls in the world. But we're not the guy with the big balls anymore, asshole. All right? You know, we can't just use comedy like that. Oh, yeah, we should just go ahead and bomb the Middle East. We don't need them. You stupid idiot. You're just an absolute moron. And it's people like you is the reason why this country's going down the tubes, man. I mean, it's being flushed down the toilet, for Christ's sake, because of idiots like you. There's people dying in the streets all over the world to get what you have, and yet you're giving it away to this authoritarian government that's trying to take control of our lives in America. And you see, is it really wrong? I mean, if the people want it in America, right? If the people are sitting here electing these pieces of crap that are obviously authoritarian, power-hungry, autocratic pieces of crap, if they elect these people and they take away our rights, is it wrong? Is it wrong? I think it's personally wrong, but, what can I do? I mean, I was on here for 5 years trying to tell you assholes to get out there and start being a little political, start understanding that, political responsibility is an element of society, and you have to go out there and be politically competent and elect statesmen that are going to be true to the constituency's needs instead of sitting out here becoming mini dictators like most politicians are. But no, we're not. We're more worried about voting for, Adam Lambert and the latest gerbil he has up his shit funnel on American Idol. That's what we're worried about. We're worried about if, this stupid bimbo from Delaware is going to, be in Dancing with the Stars, whatever the hell her teabagging name is, McConnell. That stupid witchcraft slut. Oh, yeah. Is she going to be on Dancing with the Stars? I mean, who gives a shit? You know, excuse my French. Good God. Let me take a chug of this beer here. It's disgusting. I know there's people out here that can't believe what I'm saying here, but this is America. This is goddamn America, for Christ's sake, and we're better than this. We should be more intelligent than this. We should be more civil than this. But look at us. Look at us now, right now. Look. We got the Madison, Wisconsin teachers sitting here making a ruckus because they want to continue to get paid so they can continue to do the bad job that they've been doing for the past 100 years. You know, they want to be able to continue to get pensions that increase 8% a year, every year that they're retired. They still want to get increases every year that they're employed, no matter if they're a good teacher or a bad teacher. They still want all these paid vacations and perks, and they want summers off, and they want paid summer. They want all this crap, and yet what are they producing besides nothing but a stagnant, bureaucratic piece of educational wannabe crap? That's what it is. Nobody's learning anything. The kids aren't learning anything. Let me tell you, the only thing school does is create a good kid into a corrupt soul. That's what public education does. Haven't you noticed that? Haven't you noticed that, you know, if you happen to have a kid, you send them to public education, all of a sudden they know about the most vile and disgusting things that you have never exposed them to, and yet, they know all about it. They're participating in deviant activities. Well, it's because public education, that's what it does. It screws us up, man. We don't need education. It has done nothing but allowed assholes to continue to get paid and to continue to think that, oh, they're so beautiful and so great and so, oh, look at me, I'm a teacher and I deserve this. Shut up. Shut your stupid hole. It's just a disgrace, man. Other people in the world are dying for liberty and capitalism. And, you know, you look at these people. They want to be communist. They actually believe that all this unionization crap is somehow helping society. By unionizing to exploit taxpayers and not really give a crap about everybody else, I mean, they actually believe that they're somehow helping society, that that's freedom. Have you read their signs, for Christ's sake? Look it up and read their signs. We're for the people. We're for freedom. You're for freedom? Well, how about you be free to go out in the private sector and look for your own goddamn job? How about that? How about you be free to go out there and not be judged just because, oh, look at me, I'm a bureaucrat, and by contract I got to get $1,100 or $2,000 a year increase for every year I'm employed. No. Let's have you held accountable for your ability. How about that? You know what I'm talking about? I mean, it makes me sick to my stomach when I hear these unions out here trying to, basically exploit the taxpayer, because they're exploiting me. You know, they're not paying taxes. Anybody who works for the system, anybody who works for the government, you're not paying taxes. How in the hell are you paying taxes when it's my taxes paying you? Can you explain that one to me? I mean, it's like the biggest goof of all time. I hate these stupid government employees. I don't care what part of the government you're in. I don't care if you're a municipality. I don't care if you're state. I don't care if you're federal. You people are living in a completely different reality than everybody else out here in America. And now that the economic contraction is starting to affect you assholes, all of a sudden you have a big problem. All of a sudden you're all for unions and want to be, you know, Karl Marx and Frederick Engels about this crap. It makes me sick. It makes me sick to my stomach. Everybody in the private sector has been dealing with the economic contraction since 2008. Everybody has been dealing with it. People have been getting laid off. And it doesn't matter what sector of the employment industry that you belong to, everybody has been getting laid off. Everybody's been getting pay cuts. Everybody, except for the goddamn government employees. And now that states can no longer afford to pay these gluttonous losers, all of a sudden, the unions are having a big problem, and they're in state houses all over the country pissing and moaning. I mean, it just makes me sick. You know that? It makes me sick. This is supposed to be the bastion of capitalism. Now we're turning into the bastards of communism. It makes me sick to my stomach. All over the world, people are dying to have the freedoms we have, and you idiots want to go throw us back into something that looks like communist China today. You people are sick. You know what I'm saying? You people are sick. You make me sick. I mean, good God, for Christ's sake. I got to take another drink, for Christ's sake. I mean, it's the only thing that takes away the obvious stupidity that's happening in the world today. Let me go ahead and take a drink. is the number to call here. I'm going to take some calls. Let me go ahead and uranium bathtub. Are you there?
Yeah. When your dad was growing up, did he fall off his bicycle and land on his testicles?
No, but it sounds like when your dad was growing up, he was probably whacking off to music of Liberace, because you sound like a goddamn Woody Allen butt-loving fruit bowl, for Christ's sake. I mean, Jesus Christ. What did you watch, the Teletubbies when you were a kid? What's your problem?
Yeah, I love the Teletubbies.
Yeah, you can tell, for Christ's sake. I mean, you can tell that your voice is deep, but you just prefer to sound like some, fruity ass who's playing for the pink team. For what reason? Are you gay, sir?
Ghost, will you come on a date with me to Olive Garden?
Yeah, of course. You sound like a fruity-ass Woody Allen butt lover, for Christ's sake. An internet butt stalker. All right? Why don't you take about 10 steps away from my freaking butt crack, for Christ's sake, all right? You stupid, silly freak. Super res. Okay, let's go ahead. Here comes the communist Soviet national anthem. All right, let's hear it so that you idiot Soviets that are out there listening to me thinking that communism is alive, it's dead. All right, not even the Chinese, which has been the most systematically engineered society in world history, not even them. Not even they want to live in damn communist society. So go ahead, Super Rez. Let's go ahead and hear it. Go ahead. Get him off. All right, are you kidding me? Are you honestly kidding me, for Christ's sake? You're playing a little clip of Hitler? Give me a break. 763 is calling back. What's your excuse?
Hey, I think, I don't think you should talk bad about the teachers, man.
Why?
Why should you?
Because teachers suck, and they are producing nothing but a bunch of non-cognitive reasoning children that can do nothing else but spit back knowledge on a multiple choice test. That's it.
Really? Are you sure about that? Did you go to...
Yeah, I'm sure about that. Why don't you go and talk to somebody who's young, for Christ's sake, and ask them, hey, what happened in America in World War II? Just ask them. And I'm telling you, more than half of these idiots will tell you, well, didn't we join in with Hitler and help the Germans fight against the communists? I mean, this is how stupid we've gotten out here in America, So, and it's the teacher's fault. It's the teacher's freaking fault. That's what it is. So, if you're taking offense to the fact that, you're talking about teachers, spit in your face. That's what I do. I spit in your freaking face. I spit in your face. You piece of crap. Let me go ahead and take a chug of this beer here. Nigerian in the chat room has said that Texas is 47 out of 50 when it comes to education. Well, you know what? Who gives a crap? You want to know what? Texas is the place with the jobs. You want to know why? Because Texas is the place to do business. You know what I'm saying? Texas is the place to do business, for Christ's sake. What are you talking about? So we don't even need to have an education system out here. As a matter of fact, we're cutting from our education system right now. You understand what I'm saying? So what I'm trying to say is when you're a business-friendly state and you have no state income tax, and you allow businesses to, open up shop without any kind of unions. We're a non-union state. We're what you call an at-will work state. When you're, conducting a pro-business environment, businesses come and they actually bring in the talent. You know, they bring in the educated people. You know, they bring in, you know, all the people that we need that are educated. Who gives a crap if Texans are educated? Who cares? You know, let them be farmers. Let them eat cake or something. Who cares? I don't give a crap. You know, I mean, why should I, as a property owner in Texas, be responsible for some idiot's kid going to school and getting a good education? Can somebody explain that to me? I don't even have any kids that go to school anymore. So why the hell am I continuing to pay property taxes which go to education, you know? Can you explain that to me? I don't think so. You know, I don't think, why should I have to continue to pay a $50,000 a year salary to some teacher that is nothing more than an overgrown babysitter? Can you explain that one to me? 646-652-4869. 740, you're on the air. 740, you're on the air.
I don't think so.
Oh, I'm on the air?
Yeah, what's up?
Hey, listen, I just want to ask you why you're so angry at the teachers, at the teachers union. They're defending their paychecks.
Yeah, at your expense. Yeah, you know that, at your expense. Have you learned anything, son? I mean, are you going to college on a scholarship? Are you? You're there. I'm asking. Are you going to college on a scholarship thanks to the public education system? I'm asking you a question.
I went.
Come on, spit it out. We're waiting for you. You're giving us dead air here. Come on.
What are you asking me if I went to a book?
You can't even afford a decent phone. Get him off. What are you talking about? You can't even afford a phone that can bring your damn voice up to the damn server, for Christ's sake. Look, the bottom line is that you could sit here and try to keep up and you know, promote the teachers and give them so much compassion, but they don't care about the students. If you don't believe me, if you happen to be a property owner, I strongly advise you to go and take a tour of your school. And you have every right to do that. Believe it or not, you can just say, hey, look, I paid for this school, you piece of shit, all right? I pay property taxes. I want to see what the hell's going on here in the school, and you're going to be amazed. You're going to be amazed. I'm not joking, folks. You can do this, and if they try to say you can't do it, well, then you better call your municipality and, you know, have them, you know, come down on that particular bureaucracy, because you have every right as a property tax owner to go in and visit a school to see how your tax dollars are being spent, and you're going to be sick. You're going to see that these teachers are stupid, they're dumb. You know, all they got to do is get some makeshift education degree or an emergency teacher certification, which is the biggest joke of all time. You know, I mean, teachers have become the bottom feeders of employment, for Christ's sake. I mean, everybody knows that, well, you know, the economy's bad and I'm just a loser and I don't know how to do anything else, so I'll just become a teacher. I mean, why do you think that we have a saturation of teachers? Why do you think that teachers are banging their students, you know? I mean, well, why do you think that teachers are banging their students, for Christ's sake? Because the level of credibility when it comes to teaching is low, to the point where it's just a goddamn bunch of bottom feeders, man. That's all there is. And look, we got Matt McConnell over here getting upset in the chat room saying, how dare you call teachers bottom feeders? How dare you? Well, what the hell? That's what they are. I mean, even Gloria Steinem said it. Gloria Steinem, the feminist leader, the voice of feminism, even called teachers bottom feeders there, Mike McConnell. Huh? So, you know, for you to even sit here and be judgmental towards me, why don't you go to the far left of the political spectrum and talk to Gloria Steinem, which called all teachers bottom feeders. All right? What are you talking about? I'm making a point, Matt McConnell. I'm making you look lower than a leprechaun's nutsack. I'm saying that teachers need to be put in the unemployment line. That's my point. My point is that we don't need to spend any more money on public education. We need to get rid of the Department of Education. We're talking about cutting taxes? We're talking about cutting taxes? Let's get rid of the Department of Education and privatize education. I mean, I don't understand why we haven't done this already. Don't you think that it would be a big boom if we privatized education? I mean, everybody needs it. Look at all these kids. Look at all these idiots. My kids, baby, my kids. I mean, look at all these people that are shitting out children like they're going out of style. I mean, education's obviously going to be in for the next, you know, 15, 20 years. I think it would spawn a boom of innovation and creativity if we privatized it. But no, you know what we do? We continue to remain in the stagnant bureaucracy that has been funded for 200 years, and it's done nothing. It's done nothing. I spit on public education. I spit on public teachers. All that crap. And look at it. Now I'm a corporate whore because I want to privatize education. I mean, don't you think that it would make the students better and smarter? I mean, there's an actual financial incentive. Just imagine somebody that wants to invest in a school. Just imagine somebody like, you know, that says, look, education sucks. I'm going to invest my money in my own school, and I am going to make sure that the students in my school aren't exposed to gang activity. They're not exposed to sexual deviant behavior in bathrooms. They're not exposed to all this disgusting behavior that's just, you know, becoming prevalent in our education system. They would be exposed to actual damn teachers that know their trade, that know their subject. You know, and, you know, whoever owns that school is going to make sure that that teacher knows their role, that that teacher is going to produce good products, that that teacher is going to, you know, do their job. There's no incentive for public education to make sure that teachers do their job. There is no incentive. You know that a teacher has to be damn near caught in the damn janitor's closet with their pants down with a 12-year-old before they can get fired. They can curse at a student. They can slap a student in the face. They can, you know, break a stick over a student's backside. They can do all this crap, and you know what they'll do? Because of the unions out here in America, the paid leave. We have to do an investigation, but we're going to pay them for staying at home while we're doing this investigation. That's thanks to unions right here. No, that is completely true. You know it, and I know it, and anybody who's a teacher knows it too. That's why they can curse in classrooms now. You know, I hear teachers curse out here. They're like, yeah, you know, who cares about a fuck or a shit every now and then? I mean, they're out here cursing. What a bunch of crap. No wonder our students are turning into a bunch of losers, for Christ's sake. Not only are they turning into a bunch of losers, you notice that they're emphasizing more political correctness than they are actual education. You know?
Oh, you got to be politically correct. You got to be tolerant. You got to hold hands and sing kumbaya.
You know that, you know, in public education, they've taken out in elementary school any of these harsh games that have losers, you know, or rough games like dodgeball or tag. Oh, no, we can't do that anymore. Public education, whenever they have any kind of a scholastic activity, they don't have losers anymore. They have honorable mentions, you know, honorable mentions, for Christ's sake. And look, we've got assholes in here flapping their fat Cheeto-stained fingers on the keyboard trying to justify why teachers deserve to be $50,000 a year babysitters. I don't believe it. You know, in other countries, teachers are taken seriously. You know, teachers have a role in society where they're respected. I don't respect any of these scumbags in school. I don't respect any of these people. These people are idiots. I mean, why don't you ask a teacher what they did before they became a teacher? They're going to say shit like, oh, I was a hairdresser.
Yeah, I was a hairdresser, and I went to the night school, and I mean, I'm going to go ahead and become a teacher.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not joking, man. Ask these dumbass, despicable teachers. These people are no better than you are. And that's the difference. A teacher is supposed to be better. A teacher is supposed to know more, but they don't. So give me a break. 646-652-4869. We got one more minute left in the first hour of the True Capitalist Radio program. Of course, I am your host, the man they call Ghost. And once again, I want to thank everybody for tuning in with me. Please, if you're listening to me live, tweet the program, spread it around like wildfire, blogtalkradio.com/ghost. That's blogtalkradio.com/ghost. And retweet the program, put it on all the social networking sites, You can actually take an audio widget of the True Capitalist Radio program and put it on your web page and simulcast the live broadcast. So do what you got to do, all right? Do what you got to do. 646-652-4869. I see Matt McConnell a little upset that I'm talking about teachers. Why don't you give me a call there, boy? Why don't you give me a call? 646-652-4869, you douchebag. Let me go ahead and take a drink of this beer while I'm at it. Yeah, I know there's people in here that talk garbage about me drinking all the time, but you know what? Who cares? I'm making money. I'm a capitalist. I can do that. You know? Me, cause drinking, it's fun to do. Me, cause drinking is what I like to do. Woo! Anyway, that was Dean Martin right there. Anyway, 646-652-4869. 612, you're on the air.
Hey, how you doing, buddy?
What's going on, man?
Well, you know, there's a lot to talk about here. I mean, the teachers, obviously. I mean, back in the old days, you know, when we went to school, Ghost, they just said, here's a book, learn. Now they tell you what to learn. I want you to, they have their own agendas. That's the problem, Ghost. This is what I want you to learn. My mother homeschooled my nephew, and he graduated 2 years early because guess what? Here's the books. Learn at your pace. You know, didn't give her, you know, she was from the left, but she said, listen, this is what's out here. Learn. These days, they're always trying to get in someone's pants. I mean, I'm bonded at two of my three jobs. If I did anything, committed a felony or hit anybody, I'd lose all three of my jobs, even at the airport. I understand unions, Ghost, but you can't protect the bad apples. You can't do that. And
that's what unions are there for now, man. That's what they're there for. Believe it or not, the unions are there to protect the losers. They're not there to protect people that actually want to teach and want to spread education and want to actually have children be knowledgeable. As a matter of fact, they don't even like those types of teachers. They don't even give them any respect in the public education system. You know what gets respect amongst unions? Sexual harassers of students. Believe it or not, unions, there's always a union rep coming up to the public education school that, you know, there's an alleged sexual harassment call, and the union rep actually, you know, has the job kept for whatever teacher that is accused of any kind of sexual harassment. I kid you not, that's an actual story, and I can give you much more stories than that. I mean, a damn teacher has to be caught with a kid in the damn shit stall in the boys' bathroom with their pants down before they can become fired, because if they don't, they'll have some damn union rep come in and save their job for them. It's disgusting.
I agree. I mean, that, like you said about people having kids, people have kids, ghosts, like they're taking a crap. It's not a big deal. All right, in the Middle East, I told a buddy of mine, Libya's next. I'm not surprised. I think they're going to kill him before he leaves. But you think the Saudi? I just drove by a gas station right now here in Minnesota. Ghost, it's $2.40 a gallon. I mean, $3.40 a gallon. Excuse me. Do you think Saudi Arabia will be able to compensate for the oil problem, or do you think it's going to move on to Saudi Arabia? What do you think?
I think it's going to move on to Saudi Arabia. Now, I know that the Saudi royal king is trying to pay off the people and preventing them from, you know, rising up and rioting. But I think it's way beyond that at this point. I think that, well, you know, the fervor has spread throughout the Middle East. There's a lot of disorder happening throughout that particular part of the world, and I'm really surprised that America hasn't said anything. All they're doing is a bunch of television chatter, and in my personal opinion, if we don't do anything, it's going to be a lot like World War II. Some, you know, a megalomaniac is going to take control of that region and is going to end up causing some sort of disorder for the world, and World War III could possibly ensue. I'm not trying to wish that. I'm not trying to insinuate that's going to happen, but there's a lot of damn disorder going on here, you know?
Well, you all know that's the World War III will start in the Middle East, and you know the World War IV will be fought with sticks and stones. That's where it's going to start, Ghost, is in the Middle East, and it's going to be over oil. Oil is money. We all speak one language. You know that's money, but oil is a huge thing. We live in a mechanized world, and people want the oil, and that's what it's going to come down to. And Egypt was child's play. What's going to happen in Libya, and then when it goes on to Saudi Arabia, it's going to be like wildfire, like you say. It's going to spread right to Saudi Arabia, keep right on going. You're going to see a lot of body counts in Libya because, like you said, the missionaries are going to start shooting people, and they don't care.
They're already doing it, man. They're already killing them.
They're going to go to town and sorry, with Saudi Arabia's next in like Iraq, they'll start dropping dirty bombs on them. I mean, Egypt's going to look like child's play. I mean, it's going to get nasty. And unless Saudi Arabia starts pumping gas and starts getting security in that country, we need to send some warships there to the Straits to make sure the oil gets through right now. I mean, Obama's got to get on the stick. We got to get some. We have to get some warships there to get those oil tankers through there. No problem, because if they get in there, Ghost, it's $5 a gallon in a week, and I'm not lying. You know that.
I know it, man, and I want to thank you for calling. But let me tell you, we're going to continue to see an increase because I don't see an end happening to this destabilization that's happening in the Middle East. I just don't see it. I know there's people in here that want to, you know, say that, oh, this is great, but. Remember, there could be some megalomaniac coming in there and taking control of the damn Middle East. I mean, who the hell knows? The future is uncertain. Why do you think there's such skittish mental sell-offs in the equities markets, man? Nobody knows what the hell's going to happen. You know? It's sick. It's unbelievably sick, man. Anyway, area code 213, you're on the air.
Yeah. I'm a public school teacher, and I'm offended by what you say. I go out every day, and I try to teach them children how to do math. And, you know, I'm a substitute teacher, and I don't like what you say.
Yeah, shut up and get them off. Are you kidding me? Are you choking your kid, for Christ's sake? It's the same idiot who's choking his kid so that he can get him to cry, so he can, you know, have some kind of a sound effect and sitting here talking garbage. Let me tell you something, all right? Let me tell you something right now. The kids in today's schools, let me tell you what's happening. The parents today depend on the free breakfast and the free lunch that public education supplies students. Yeah. And what happens is the parents, they don't bother to buy their kids any kind of food. Instead, they're putting in their Dolce Gabbana glasses and their Coach purses and their Louis Vuitton bags and stuff like that. So they actually utilize the free breakfast and the free lunch program, which is in school, which, by the way, was invented by the Black Panther Communist Party. True story. And yet we've just, you know, allowed individuals that shit out these kids, five, six, seven different fathers, to abuse the free breakfast, free lunch. And you know that they actually have a free after-school snack? They actually have free after-school, like a little daycare program, like a little after-school program, so that these parents can just dump them off at 6 in the morning. They can get themselves a free breakfast and just sit there at the school and be babysat by these administrators and these teachers. They get a free lunch, all right? And then after school, what do? They go to the gym, and then they go and have a little after school, little program or whatever, and then they get an after school snack, all right? So inevitably, these mothers, single mothers, and these disgusting parents that don't care about their kids anyway, they don't have to feed their kids. And let me tell you how I know that this affects the economics of loser parents. In 2009, we had this, swine flu. Do you remember that right? Swine flu epidemic that came out in Texas out here? It was out here in Cibolo, Texas, down south of Austin. You know, that Cibolo, Texas, I believe, was the first case where, you know, swine flu or avian flu, whatever the hell it was, and it started spreading around everywhere. H1N1, that's what the hell it was, H1N1. Anyway, the school district of Cibolo decided to close down because they didn't want to have this H1N1 epidemic engulfing everybody that was in school. Well, in the news, in the very next day, I swear on my mother, I swear on anything that's holy, this was an actual news report. Okay, I swear to God. These mothers came on the television and said after they closed down the schools to prevent the spread of H1N1, they got on and said, well, what am I supposed to do, baby? I mean, I depend on those breakfasts. I depend on that free lunch. Now I got to take money out of my pocket. I got to take money out of my pocket to feed my kids. I mean, what are we supposed to do? I kid you not. I mean, I'm not joking. That's an actual interview from some of these disgusting, despicable single whore mothers out of Cibolo, Texas, they were more concerned about, you know, getting the free lunch and free breakfast than they were about their kid catching H1N1. What a disgusting disgrace. Utterly disgusting. But let me tell you, that's what America is today, folks. All right? That's what America is today. It's a disgrace. It's disgusting. These people don't care about their kids. And if you happen to be a young kid listening to me, which you shouldn't be because this is a mature, rated show here, but if you happen to be a kid listening to me, if you're being raised by some single mother and she's collecting any of these entitlements, or she's going to nonprofit organizations and getting free food, or if she's going out there getting her rent paid by, you know, church groups or whatever, she's a piece of crap. You understand that? She's a piece of trash, and you should not look up to her just because she's your mother. You should spit on that bimbo. You should spit on that bimbo. You shouldn't sit here and embrace some whore who shitted you out of her vaginal wall and doesn't have enough money to feed you, that doesn't have enough care in the world to go out and get a job and feed you properly and raise you properly. All right? That single mother is a dirty, disgusting dish rag whore. All right? And if anybody's going to sit here and going to deny it, well, you don't know your ass from your elbow. All right? 404, you're on the air.
Ghost, how's it going, man?
What's going on, man?
Hey, it's been a while. Got to say, you know, I got kicked in the nuts like a lot of other people the last couple days in the market. That's all right. No big deal.
It's the equities market, man. But if you're long-term, everything should be fine, man. I think everything's going to pan itself out. I think,
you don't
remember that private enterprise is holding on to $3 trillion. They're just sitting on it. We're waiting for these tax initiatives that Barack Obama is going to give corporations, and once that happens, you're going to see a lot of investment, even with the high prices, if there happens to be high prices in oil. I think that, for the long term, America looks fairly decent for the next 2 years until the Bush tax cuts wear out.
Yeah, you don't lose till you sell out, but I had to chime in. You know, I had a buddy of mine that I went to school with, and he went to school to be a teacher. And he's out of he's in another state than Wisconsin, but I asked him what his thoughts were on it. And prior to going to school, he was a pretty conservative guy, or would have been what I would consider a capitalist. But man, after about 2 years, he's drank the Kool-Aid now, and he's already bitching and crying. You know, his heart's bleeding for these poor fucking teachers up in Wisconsin. And it's just sad to see the collective mentality. It's an embarrassment.
And you know what? What's really sad is that they're not teaching the students. If they were teaching the students and we were number one in math and science and we were producing the best doctors and, you know, we had the best scientists, I mean, you know, then maybe I'd be like, all right, well, go ahead and give the teachers what they want. But they're not producing crap. We're 30th in science and math. We're no longer the superpower in America. And a lot of the reason why we're not the superpower in America is because of the damn education system, for Christ's sake. And 404, you hung up there. If you can call back, we were having a conversation, but go ahead and call back up, man. But anyway, you know, it's the education system that has screwed up society. I mean, do you know that the Chinese at this point in time, even with their totalitarian systematic setup, that they have developed teleportation technology? You can look that up. I know that you people think that I'm lying, but look that up for yourself. China has already developed teleportation technology. They're on the brink and on the cusp of really futuristic type science. And what are we doing? What are we doing in America? A boner pill. Oh, yeah, let's get a boner pill. And Rogaine. You know, if you're a bald prick and want to, you know, sprout out the last remaining roots of hair that you got on your bald head and do a comb over, buy Rogaine. I mean, give me a break. Good God. Let me take a swig of this beer here. Good stuff. 646-652-4869. We're going to take a couple more callers here. 111, you're on the air.
Hey, Ghost. How's it going?
Not bad, man. What you up to, man?
I'm driving home from school right now. That's why I want to give a shout out to my friend Stefan. I know he's sitting back on campus listening right now. So I'll say what's up to him. I know he's cracking a dose of keys, just chilling. Well, I read this news story the other day on chasefisher.org, and...
Yeah, shove it up your ass, all right? Shove it up your ass, you stupid loser, all right? Anyway, 646-652-4869. We got, who else we got here? We got Vitoci. Are you there, Vitoci?
Yeah, I'm here. Hey, Ghost, it's Vince in the Bay.
What's going on, man?
Hey, nothing much. I'm just, like, kind of monitoring all this crap that's going on in Wisconsin, and it's getting, just when you think it can't get any more ridiculous, now you got these, you got people trolling the governor. Yes, trolling is not limited just to your show, Ghost. It also is happening to the governor now. Did you hear about this guy from some online blog, prank called Governor Walker pretending to be one of the Koch brothers? Did you hear about that?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I did hear about it, and we were going to allude to that in a second, but I haven't been able to get a copy of the prank call, and until I get a copy of it, I would probably, I'd want to air it.
Yeah, I listened to a good part of it, and there's no gotcha moment, there's no smoking gun. This guy, Ian Murphy, he's the editor of a website, Buffalo Beast, whatever the fuck that is.
That sounds professional. Yeah, there you go.
Exactly. So this guy crank calls him, pretending to be David Koch, one of these Koch brothers that the pinheads on the left love to demonize, just like the idiots on the right like to demonize George Soros. But anyways, this guy somehow, I guess, convinced Scott Walker, the governor, that he was this guy David Koch, and had him on the phone for 20 minutes, and I honestly, I think that maybe Scott Walker was onto it, because if you listen to the tape, you go back and listen to it, the guy that's pretending to be David Koch just sounds like a complete idiot. He just gets in little jabs on people and, calling like Mika Brzezinski a hot piece of ass. Shit like that where, it's kind of obvious that he was trolling him. And I think what Scott Walker was doing was he kept a pretty straight face through the entire thing, didn't give him anything juicy. I mean, he talked to him for 20 minutes and didn't, like, let his guard down at all, really. And the best that any of the people on Twitter could come up with was that, it was revealing how chummy he was. But it didn't even sound like they were being chummy. I mean, the guy sounded like he was giving an interview.
The leftist media out here on the mainstream media is trying to claim that, somehow he alluded to the fact that he was going to plant agitators in the crowd.
No. If you listen to it, he tries to set him up. He says, hey, what do you think about planting some people? And Walker says, we talked about that, but no, we're not going to do that. And you could easily say that, hey, maybe he was just – baiting him a little bit. He didn't say anything, damning to his character. He didn't do any. He didn't say anything illegal. If anything, I think it makes the guy Ian Murphy, this idiot for this website Buffalo Beast, it totally wipes away any journalistic integrity this guy ever had any delusions of attaining, because it makes him look like a troll, which is exactly what these goddamn journalists are these days. They're no better than these trolls that call into your show and try to get you to talk about whatever the fuck they want to talk about. These idiots that call into your show and go on 4chan and think they're all high and mighty. This guy Ian Murphy from Buffalo Beast is no better, no worse.
No kidding, man. I mean, I mean the media today made it sound like there was a smoking gun here that he was going to plant agitators. It's really disgusting. That's why I've been trying to look for the call. I couldn't find it. I got it.
I'll send it to you. For some reason, I can't link into your chat. But if you go to Mediaite, you ever been to Mediaite.com?
No, I haven't been there, but I'll look it up.
Yeah, if you go to Mediaite, it's Mediaite.com. They have it on there. They have it broken up on YouTube in two different things. And it was interesting. Mediaite tends to be left-leaning, just so you know. But they have the unedited tapes in two YouTube videos on there.
Unbelievable how the the unions are going to this point to try to continue to sustain all these unreasonable pay benefits and 8% increase a year for retirements. And I mean, it's just amazing. I mean, they even bust in the students who were off because of the teacher strike last week. They even bust in these kids to the state capitol. And I don't know if you've heard, you know, the sound clip of that, but they didn't even know why they were there. They were just, hey, it's a fun thing to do. We're off today from school. And I mean, it's sick, really, what these people are doing. And what's really sad is that everybody else besides these disgusting government employees has felt the economic contraction of 2008 up until this point. I mean, it's still – I mean, I know there's people thinking that this is a recovery. I don't think it's that much of a recovery. And, you know, for these teachers and these employees to sit here and try to, you know, make it seem like, oh, it's for the people, and trying to make this image as if whatever this government's doing is somehow, you know, against the people's will, or it's authoritarian, or it's something bad. The government doesn't have any more money to continue this disgusting charade of paying employees seniority pay every year that they're there, or paying employees the last year of their salary before they retire and then having an 8% increase each year. There's no money for this crap, and they don't want to deal with it. I think that it's rather disgusting for anybody who got laid off, anybody who was anybody who got foreclosed on, anybody who's you know, basically felt the economic contraction. I think it's a disgrace that these teachers who finally have to feel it, even though they didn't feel it in 2008, they finally have to feel it, and all of a sudden it's a great American tragedy because they have to. It's a disgrace, man. It's horrible.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And the thing I don't get in this whole thing is what is so important about collective bargaining rights to begin with? Like, personally, I think if you can't negotiate your own salary, you've got bigger problems, all right? If you need to, if you need to join a group and band together with people because you can't think straight enough for yourself to decide how much your labor is worth, then you got much bigger problems than how much you're making.
No kidding. And what's really sad is that the reason that they want this collective bargaining is so that the worst can continue to sustain themselves off this taxpayer-funded bureaucratic system, as opposed to the best getting promoted and getting bigger positions. I mean, the system itself, the education system, is set up to make sure that everybody, even including the worst teachers and the best teachers, are all at the same level. That's communism. That's how it works. And what's unfortunate is that it's finally had its side effect on our students. We can see it via these prank calls and American Idol and skins on MTV. I mean, we can see the side effects of this crap. And it sucks that, you know, anybody who tries to highlight this, like myself, I'm a bad guy. I don't know if you've seen YouTube lately, but, you know, there's somebody by the name of Ghost Fan that put up a the time that I called Madison, Wisconsin, and, you know, I don't know, told off some teacher or something. Well, the comments I see on that particular YouTube video is disgraceful. As if I'm the bad guy because I don't care about teachers. As if I'm the bad guy because I'm stating the obvious, that these teachers' unions are using the students so that they can increase their pay, so that they can continue to be stagnant, so they can continue to teach us students the test, a multiple choice test, a bubble in test, as opposed to understanding things critically and interpreting things in a cognitive, reasonable manner. It's disgraceful, man.
Absolutely. Hey, Ghost, one last thing. I have a question for you.
What's up?
You think? Okay. Well, first of all, you think oil is going to go hit 200 here pretty soon, right?
Well, I think maybe Brent crude will hit 200. I don't know about sweet crude. Sweet crude, I'm thinking about maybe 125, 130, maybe
really?
150. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. I was going to ask you at what date do you think, if you could predict, just for shits and giggles, if you could predict when you think it's going to hit its new peak.
Man, I really don't know. I think any point within the next month.
Really? See, I'm thinking it will probably crest. Usually, it always crests in the the summer driving season, like July. So I'm thinking in July you might see 175 maybe.
Well, you
at
know
least,
why
at
I
least
think that we won't see that?
I mean, we're already
you
at 100.
Know why? Well, no. You want to know why we won't see that? Because we already hit 100 today. We know we're going to hit 100 tomorrow. We know that unrest is going to continue to happen throughout the region. But at the same time, within the next 2 months, at some point, the market, which is the American people and the people in the international community, the emerging markets, they're going to curb their driving. They're going to curb their consumption of oil. And even though it may be scarce, even though it may be going up, in my personal opinion, and if you look at the trends on how people react to high gas prices and high oil prices, they do trim back. And the demand decreases, and by default, even when there's scarcity in the market, by default, the price of oil comes down. So, I mean, even in July, even when it's supposed to be at the bulk of driving season, I think at that point we would see I don't think that we would see 175. I think that we would still be $100 a barrel, but I don't think that we would see that high a price on sweet because I think, because Americans do, they curb their driving, they curb their energy intake, and as a result, I mean, you know, it affects the market in that regard. So at some point, in my opinion, I think that, you know, the consumer will rectify the market.
Well, yeah, and there's another thing that comes into play as well as far as market forces. At least this is what happened last time it went up to 150, was that when you get to a certain price point, it becomes there's a point where other players can join the market and get into the oil game and start making money off it. And when it gets to that point, a lot of the big boys, like your OPECs and your BPs and all the big shots, they start flooding all their reserves, and you get nation states that flood their reserves and bring the prices back down, like they did where they went to 150 and then brought it back down to 30.
Well, you're not taking into consideration that Saudi Arabia is trying to curb its own unrest. And I know that the Saudi royal king is trying to pay them off by, you know, forgiving debts, by giving interest-free loans, by giving people unemployment. But I think it's too far gone, man. I think that at this point in time, the whole community of the Middle East is starting to realize that there was a big contradiction in worshiping these particular monarchies, which have no precedent in Arab culture. There is no precedent that says that, oh, yeah, there was an Arab monarchy for 2,000 years. No. The monarchy of the royal family happened after World War I. All these royal families, all these Arab countries that are being overthrown, they were established after World War I. Once the Ottoman Empire fell, it fell after World War I because they backed up the Austrian-Hungarian Empire, and, you know, that side of World War I lost. And as a result, England, France, and all the European powers started carving up the old Ottoman Empire like it was a piece of cake. And before you know it, the reason that they were able to establish these countries is because the old story of Lawrence of Arabia. For you folks that aren't familiar with Lawrence of Arabia, he was a secret secret organization in the CIA of England, whatever the hell that is. And he went out there within the Ottoman Empire, posed as an Arab, posed as somebody in the headdress and the garb, and actually negotiated with the tribes throughout the Ottoman Empire, negotiated with these tribes so that the Ottoman Empire could wither away from within. And that's what happened. The Ottoman Empire, even though they were conducting, you know, military operations outside the country, Lawrence of Arabia was conducting all these secret negotiations for the British government with the tribes in the Ottoman Empire, and as a result, they became the royal families. The heads of the tribes became the royal families. This is why you have these countries in Arabia or in the Middle East that have
despotic royal families or dictators. Because the reason there's dictators in the Middle East is because they overthrew the monarchies of old. Henceforth, the Shah of Iran was overthrown by the Iranian Revolution of 1979. The king of Iraq was overthrown by Saddam and the Ba'ath Party in, what was it, 1970-something, early 70s, something like that. It was actually in the 60s, the late 60s, early 70s. We can go on and on. But the problem is that until we start realizing that this is what the Middle East is repelling against, this is what the Middle East is rising up and rioting and protesting and causing revolution for, that's the only way we're going to realize when this particular episode of unrest is going to stop. Anyway, folks, I'm going to go ahead and take a break here, folks. Once again, I want to thank everybody for tuning in live with me. Also, I want to thank the sponsors. And for you folks that are listening in, please visit the sponsors. We got a sponsor right now who is somebody who sponsors the show during the actual audio live broadcast. And we're talking about none other than Lexington Law. If you happen to have a low credit score, bankruptcy, or any kind of financial trouble, give these guys a call. They're sponsoring the True Capitalist Radio Show, so if you have any kind of financial trouble, why don't you just give them a call? Give them a couple of minutes, see what they can do for you, man. 877-663-2171 is the number. All right? I'm not joking around. I mean, I know there's people out there listening in. They're like, I want to get in the stock market. I want to buy a house. I want to get into real estate. I want to do all these things, but I got bad credit. I got financial trouble. I got a bankruptcy. Well, give them a call. Get a pad and paper right now. 877-663-2171. All right? And let me tell you, the Lexington Law here at 877-663-2171, they can help you out. I mean, they can remove items from credit, the whole nine yards. Give them a call right now. All right? Now, I'm going to go ahead and take a break here, folks. We are celebrating Black History Month once again. And as a result, we're playing black artists. We're playing black artists to commemorate Black History Month. And this next artist, this is an actual song I like, all right? This is by Rick James. Rick James, biatch! This is actually by Rick James, and he actually wrote this song. It's a sweet song about some lady named Mary Jane. Obviously, he had an infatuation with her. Very, very beautiful song, for Christ's sake. So I really like it. Whoever Mary Jane is, she must be a lucky girl, because this was a great song written by Rick James, unlike that super freak, and all that crap. So anyway, without any further ado, Rick James, biatch, and Mary Jane.
Mary Jane. listening to Ghost
on True Capitalist Radio.
True Capitalist Radio.
All right, we're back, and hopefully you appreciate a little bit of Rick James, biatch, and a little bit of Mary Jane. Let me tell you, that's a sweet song about whoever he's talking about. I mean, whoever the woman is, Mary Jane, very sweet song. And, you know, that the reason I played that song is for everyone out there who's been emailing me up saying that I'm being a racist because I'm playing gangster rap and to commemorate Black History Month. Well, there you go. There's a nice, sweet song from Rick James about some girl named Mary Jane. And all you idiots that are calling me a racist, well, you don't know your ass from your goddamn elbow. All right, let me go ahead and take a – well, as a matter of fact, I need another beer here. Let me get another beer going on here. Oh, yeah. Cheers to everybody out there, folks. Cheers. 646-652-4869 is the number to call. Let's take another swig here. Ah, that's what I'm talking about. Anyway, what else are we going to talk about here? We talked about Muammar Gaddafi hiring African mercenaries to hire to murder protesters. I want to talk a little bit about this socialist population of Greece. That's right, I'm talking about Greece, these assholes that are pissing and moaning that, oh, that doesn't fit. We want socialism, we want to be able to retire at 45, and we want to be able to get the money from the government, and it's not fair. They're rioting in the streets for socialism in Greece, folks. They are rioting in the streets for socialism. It's disgusting. They're throwing Molotov cocktails and setting police on fire because they want to continue to have some socialist crap. Look it up for yourself. You don't believe me, you milky lickers. 646-652-4869 is the number to call. Is the number to call. Let's go ahead and take some calls here, shall we? 646, you're on the air.
Hi.
Yeah, what's going on?
My friend said that I should destroy you because you're a stupid fucking redneck, basically.
Yeah, you sound like some stupid ditzy bimbo that's probably some fat in the ass chick or some ugly hook nose that has to get online and, you know, go to these little 4chan forums so you can be worshipped by a bunch of anime-watching jerk nuts because you have no actual real life or anybody actually giving you any props in the street. So, Bimbo, if you're going to sit over here and win brownie points with the hard legs out here on, you know, E-Bombs, 4chan, or wherever, you have to talk with a little bit more lulls than that, you stupid mumbling over the tongue having slut, all right? I mean, give me a break. And then you're going to hang up. You're going to hang up now. You're going to hang up. You see, that's what I don't like about these bimbos that are, you know, and let me tell you, I don't have nothing against, you know, 4chan, E-bombs, or anything of that nature. They do get on my fucking nerves, but what I don't like is these bimbos that, you know, they get on, like, YouTube, or they put pictures of themselves on these posts, and you know as well as I that nobody's hitting that in their local region, wherever the hell they're at. So they got to get online and make sure that a bunch of fat computer dorks give her the stroke that she wants, that, you know, that she sees on TV, like from, you know, Desperate Housewives. She wants the stroke, you know, she wants the stroke from these assholes and be like, oh, yeah, you're so hot and all. Oh, yeah. I think you're a stupid, slutty bitch that needs to get out of the house. That's what I think you need to do there, slut. All right? Where the hell did you go anyway? You hung up faster than, you know, some slut looking, you know, for a $2 slut bag. And, you know, anyway, never mind. Let me go ahead and, Patrick, you there, Patrick? Shove it up your ass. Hey, what's going on? 404, you're back on the air.
Hey, Ghost. Sorry about that, man.
No, it's all good, man. It happens, you know. What's up? What's up?
Yeah, you know, I have to say, I thought you were joking about the whole Miller High Life deal, and then I was walking in the grocery store the other day, and sure enough, on the tall boys, I fucking look over.
I'm not joking. I wasn't joking.
I couldn't believe it. I was I just started dying laughing. I had to buy it. I had to buy the cans. I thought they're collector's edition, so that's one of my investments.
Yeah, I mean, let me tell you, I know there's Mexicans all over the country that are writing in saying, man, where are my Wetas? This is not fair, because that's what they call these. Out here in Texas, we got a lot of Mexicans walking around out here, and that's what they call these damn things. They call these damn things Wetas. But then when you got a black model on the can, it kind of just, you know, puts a whole new spin on the whole thing, especially, you know, Mexicans. I mean, you know, they're not, especially them Cholo Vato Locos, they're not too fond of the black persuasion, to say the least.
No. I'm, you know, not my cup of tea either, but hey, whatever, to each his own. but hey, you know, one of the things I was looking at, and I don't know if I certainly haven't heard a whole lot, but the one thing that I'm kind of wondering is, you know, Obama up there, he's sitting there trying to save his ass. I'm surprised he hasn't tried to chime in more, if he hasn't done so already, on this whole Wisconsin teachers thing.
Well, actually, he has tried to chime in on it. He's actually thrown his support for public unions here. He's actually thrown his support, which has actually, you know, gone completely against what the states need. You know, I mean, you know, the states need to cut spending so that they can be able to suffice, you know, the actual things government's supposed to do in states, like build roads and, you know, parks and, you know, government bureaucracy to, you know, go to court and all that crap. You know?
Yeah. Well,
what's really sad is that, you know, the teachers just don't care.
No.
They just don't give two rats asses, man.
No. As I said, I mean, my one friend, he's I mean, he's totally drank the Kool-Aid, believes that, you know. I even asked him point blank. I said, you're telling me that it shouldn't be a pay-for-performance as far as teachers go, and you believe that, you know, someone who's sitting over there, you know, not teaching the kids or not doing anything and, you know, not chipping or doing their part should get your pay and you should just get an annual, you know, seniority raise every year? And, you know, he didn't answer me on it, but, I mean, no answer basically tells me that, yeah, he's drank the Kool-Aid on that.
You're exactly right. That's what these damn teachers are fighting for. They're not doing it for the kids. It makes
me
sick when I hear these goddamn teachers say, no, we're doing it for the kids. You're doing it for your pension. You're doing it for your salary. You're doing it for your damn self, you sick, twisted, bureaucratic piece of communist worshiping crap. I spit on teachers once again. Pwah! Spit on them. Excuse me. Let me take a swig of this, but go ahead.
Yeah, and you know, the one thing I got to say is that I went to public school for my first 2 years in high school, and I have to say I was dumb as dog shit. After that, I was fortunate enough to be able to go to a private school for the rest of the time, and I'd say in those 2 years, I probably learned more in 2 years than I learned for the rest of my entire public school education after that. I mean, pretty much the only thing I learned, the only thing that kids are taught in public school, at least the dumb bimbo girls, were how to give head, and that's about it.
And, you know, what's really sad is that's actually rather appropriate. Because what's unfortunate is that these girls nowadays, they're learning from their cougar mothers. They're learning that they can go to, you know, a place with no money and at the end of the night have everything. You know, like their moms, they go to the bar, they have no cash, and yet they're sloppy drunk at the end of the night with some dude, you know, buying them some McDonald's or something, or a bag of, you know, fast food at the end of the night. They're learning from their mothers that they can just go out and, you know, get some entitlement or get some housing voucher program, government cheese, welfare, or whatever. They can just have kids and have, you know, serious capital coming into them through entitlements. It's disgraceful.
Yeah, and you hit it right on the head yesterday when you mentioned about the dumb bimbos at these bars when they sit there and the first thing they say is, what do you do for a living? And, you know, if you don't have a good answer for that, or you don't have, you know, $100 taped to your schlong, then they're not going to talk to you.
No, they're not going to talk to you whatsoever. And let me tell you, even if they do talk to you, you better be sure that they're interested in you. I mean, I've seen it out here in Austin, Texas. I go out here to 6th Street all the time. And I like to just observe when I'm just sitting at a bar, you know,
A lot of the bartenders know me out here. I just sit there and just have a couple of drinks. Sometimes I'll take the wife, and I can just see from afar, you know, one guy just, you know, going out and, you know, spending all this money on this disgusting ditzy bimbo, you know, spending about $5-$10 on, you know, the most expensive drink, because, you know, of course the broad can't just have a beer. She's got to have, oh, I want a Mai Tai, or I want a triple layer kamikaze, or I want, you know, some ridiculous crap like that. And before you know it, the guy's dropping $70 in the hole just trying to, you know, wine and dine this bimbo out here at the bar. And lo and behold, last call comes around, an ethnic minority comes around her, and she's out the door when this guy goes to take a piss or something. She's out the door with that damn ethnic minority, for Christ's sake, and the guy's just sitting there after he gets out of the damn bathroom like, wait a minute, what happened to that girl? What happened?
Man, getting the high hard one.
That's America. That's America.
Yeah, well, I mean, the way you look at it is she capitalized on him and can't. I mean, hey, that's the game, you know. But my thing is, you know, you can't get sucked into that game. And fortunately, I'm lucky enough to have a good girl with me, so I don't have to worry about that shit anymore. But
no kidding,
anyway.
Good for you, man. I mean, you know, and make sure that she doesn't get sucked in by media, man, because they can get sucked in by the media and their friends too. Oh, Jesus Christ, they're freaking friends. And let me tell you something else. Their friends will actually start hating on you. They'll actually start hating on her and try to actually move in and, you know, give you a free, you know, waxing of your carrot or something just so that they can prove to their – I'm not joking. They'll try to sit here and pull the balls out of your pants just so that they can say to their friend, oh, you see, he's just sitting on there and he's just talking and he doesn't love you. And before you know it, at the end of the week after the breakup, the best friend's with your old man. That's just how it is. You know?
You got that shit right. I know there's a couple of the girls out there, but you know that's also you got to blame it on that those shitty ass Jersey Shore. What is it? The fucking Real Housewives of.
Nah, you
got to
blame it on all that. Like Bethany Frankel. Have you seen the disgusting mug on that slut? And we're supposed to sit here and justify. I mean, haven't you noticed that we're just justifying like plastic bimbos as faces? And all of a sudden, guys are like, well, if this is what we're going to fuck, I mean, we're going to just have to do it. I mean, is this what guys are banging out here? You know, these disgusting fat-lipped, you know, stretched-faced, it looks like silly putty over your knee, disgusting scowls out here. I mean, look at Kardashian, for Christ's sake. Look at Kardashian. I mean, look, I'll give it to you. You know, 2 or 3 years ago, okay, you know, whatever, she was all right. But, I mean, I saw the porno tape, or I saw her with Ray J. I wouldn't want to bang her. All she does is just sit there and, I mean, you know, it's like, why even get with her if you're just going to have a hole there? I mean, you're supposed to be doing something, you stupid slut. You're supposed to be the most provocative slut out here in the world. You should be knowing how to, you know, work a Johnson from 6 ways from Sunday. And yet she's just laying there and, anyway, I'm sorry, man. I don't. I'm just going. It just pisses me off that this is what America is here. This is it.
No, I mean that's the way it goes. But hey, you know, nothing to worry about. And I'm just like you said. I'm just going to keep on capitalizing and enjoying it, and sit back and watch all these other stupid assholes play the game. So.
That's right, man. Just keep on capitalizing and don't worry about it. I know that there's a sell-off today, but if you're a long-term investor, just like Buffett was, just like anybody who's made some serious capital on the market is, you'll be all right. Remember, equities are worth more than money. Equities are worth more than money in this day and age.
No, I ain't selling.
And if you accumulate enough equities, man, I'm telling you, you know, before you know it, these banks will start coming to you. These banks will be like, well, you need a loan. You got collateral. You got this. I mean, they're gonna send you crap. And that's how you get started in your life. You know, you want to live in a badass condominium like Ghost is over here. You want an office. You want this. You want that. Learn about corporations. You know, start your own business. Even if all you do is trade all day, you know, start your own business. Learn the difference between sole proprietorship, partnership, corporations. Learn about all that sort of thing. I mean, I'm a corporation. That's why I can write off this radio broadcast. Because I'm doing it out of my office, and, you know, all the booze that I'm drinking it out of my office. It's in my office fridge, so I can justify all these expenses because it's an actual business expenditure. You know, so, you know, if you start learning all these things, you know, you start, you know, reaping the rewards. Remember, there's a lot of corporate loopholes out here. You know, the worst thing you could do is make a lot of money as a sole proprietor. That's all I can say.
Yeah. Yeah, and I love that guy the other day who started hating on you, that Jerry or whatever that started trying to hate on you for having $400 bottles of scotch.
He sounded really upset, didn't he? Like, what are you talking about, baby? You got a $400 bottle of scotch, man? That ain't cool, man. We got poor people in America, man, starving to death.
I called that poor bastard up one time on his show and told him, I'm like, yeah, you know, you're really starting to piss me off because I'm trying to go from a 3 Series BMW to a 7 Series. He flew off the handle. It was hilarious.
He's like, man, what are you talking about, man? We the poor people of Chicago, baby. What you doing talking about that shit, Willis?
He said he was going to rip me out of the car, and he said if I drive down in his neighborhood, they'd pull me out of the car and shoot me.
Man, I wouldn't take a crap in Chicago, man. Speaking of Chicago, did you hear about Rahm Emanuel up in here, this piece of, half of middle finger crap, sitting here winning the election? I mean, that just goes to show you that the American people are a bunch of idiots.
Yeah.
You know, Jerry from Chicago, I don't mean to be hating on the man because, you know,
no.
He did call my first show whenever I did. I mean, he's been around for a while. He's a guy who's been around Blog Talk Radio as long as I have. But what I don't appreciate is that during, 2008, when I was conducting these broadcasts as True Conservative Radio, this guy actually called me up and saying, man, Obama, baby, you need to vote for Obama. He's going to get the poll in America. You know, all this crap, every show. You can look back in the archive. You don't believe me. Okay?
Oh, yeah, you're right.
And lo and behold, Obama's in office. You know, he's been given, you know, more taxpayer money to corporate multinational American conglomerates than any other American president in American history. He's given more, perks to corporations, and he's about to even cut the corporate taxes even more. And now that Jerry and the Poe people of Chicago ain't reaping the benefits, all of a sudden Obama's a bad guy. Weren't you for this guy? Weren't you just laying your life? You were like, baby, Obama's the second coming, baby. He black Jesus, baby. He black Jesus. I mean, weren't you all like that? All of a sudden now, you know, he's basically becoming the black Ronald Reagan. All of a sudden, they don't like him. I mean, what gives, man? I mean, I thought it was, I don't know. I just don't get it, man. I don't know. Maybe I'm making something out of nothing. I don't know.
Yeah. Well, Ghost, all I got to say is I'm glad you're back, man. This awesome show every night. Can't give you enough credit, man. So take it easy.
All right, no problem, man. Thank you for calling up, man. All right, I appreciate it. Anyway, 646-652-4869 is the number to call here. We're in the house is the True Capitalist Radio Program. I am your host, the man they call Ghost, and folks, I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in with me. If you're tuning in live, folks, please retweet the program. Tell everybody you know about the True Capitalist Radio Show, folks. All right, blogtalkradio.com/ghost is the official website. All right, is the official website of the True Capitalist Radio Program, baby. All right, and at the same time, don't forget to email me up. I've put out basically a call to anybody who is going to make a YouTube video that's going to promote the True Capitalist Radio Program. All right, I want a viral video. I've seen a couple of them out there. If you look up True Capitalist Radio on YouTube, there's a couple of them out there that are viral, that are going out there and trying to spread the True Capitalist Radio Show like wildfire. But I want more. Like I said, by, what was the date that I said? Let me see. March 11th. March 11th is the date and the deadline. So if you happen to be somebody that needs some cash, all right, and you know how to make a decent, cool, viral video, well, go out and make a viral video about the True Capitalist Radio Program, and I will give you $200, baby. Woo! Why? Because I'm a capitalist, and I can do that. Let me go ahead and take a chug of this beer here. Ah, I'm a capitalist, and I can do that. And that's why I'm saying, folks, I like the YouTube videos that are out there now, but I want to get viral. I know that there are some UK people and some people from Ireland, Scotland, Europe that want to do viral videos, but they're afraid that they're not going to be able to get mainstream media, because I am paying more if you happen to get mainstream media. They're not going to be able to get mainstream media in the American media markets. And I said, I don't care. I don't care if you get media in the UK market. I don't care if you get media in the damn Australian market. I don't care, you know? What I want is I want everybody to spread the word like a wildfire. True Capitalist Radio Program. We need capitalists. We need more capitalists. We need more capitalists, for Christ's sake. 646-652-4869. We got Pineapple Meister. Were you there? Get him off, man. Get him off. Give me a break. All right, we got 1096-01. Are you there?
Hello. Please leave a message after the tone. Hey, somebody pick up the phone, please, in Madison, Wisconsin. All right? I mean, we're watching this on the news over here, and we want to know what in the blue hell is happening. All right? You understand what I'm talking about? We want to know what's going on, so pick up the goddamn phone. This is ridiculous. These unions are ruining the country. You're sitting here trying to justify your strife against these kids. Against these kids, for Christ's sake? I mean, give me a break. You should all be ashamed of yourself. Get them off.
You're damn right they should be ashamed of themselves.
All right, let's do another one because this is disgusting. This is a disgrace. I want to talk to somebody.
I'm glad you called up with that little clip. I don't know if that's Ghost Fan. There's somebody out there on YouTube called Ghost Fan that's actually going out there and posting some nice clips of yours truly, because obviously they want the $200. So if that's him, thank you for calling up, because let me tell you something. We're about to approach the third hour, the third freaking hour of True Capitalist Radio. And you know what? I feel like calling Wisconsin. Yeah, that's right. I feel like calling Wisconsin right now. Well, maybe not right now. I got to take a break here first, you know, because, you know, I've been chugging beer and, you know, I take a lead a whiz, for lack of a better term. But what we're going to do here, once we go on break here in the next 10 minutes, what I'm going to do, for you folks that aren't familiar with this, I am going to call random numbers in Wisconsin in hopes of getting somebody on the horn to try to justify this union uprising, this public union uprising. I mean, these are unions that are exploiting the taxpayer. Do you understand that? They're exploiting it. Exploiting the goddamn taxpayer, and it makes me sick. And they have no shame, and they're bringing in the students. They're exploiting everybody, and I want some answers, and I want them now. Anyway, folks, this is the absolute third hour of the True Capitalist Radio Program. All right, I am your host, the man they call Ghost. Once again, folks, please retweet the program. Tell everybody you know about the True Capitalist Radio Show. There is no advertisement when it comes to the True Capitalist Radio Program. I don't go out here and advertise this show. This is a pure word-of-mouth show. You want to talk about digital culture? This man right here. They should be writing articles about me, for Christ's sake. What are you talking about? I've been out here for 5 years. All right? Why don't you do a Google search? Why don't you do a YouTube search? Why don't you do a Bing search about True Capitalist Radio, True Conservative Radio, and Ghost himself? And then you'll see what's going on. Then you know what's going on. Anyway, folks, please spread the link around like wildfire. blogtalkradio.com/ghost. That's blogtalkradio.com/ghost. Spread it around like wildfire. All right? Oh, man, I'm getting hyper here because I want people to spread the word, for Christ's sake. I want people to tell everybody.
I mean, get creative, for Christ's sake. I mean, look at what those idiots have done in Egypt. I mean, look at what Whale Ghanem did in Egypt, for Christ's sake. He was able to call it a revolution. Why don't we spread the damn word about capitalism so we can have more capitalists, so we can have more winners in this global society, instead of a bunch of losers with their hands out expecting something from someone else? That's what I'm saying, folks. Please, spread the damn word about the True Capitalist Radio program. Don't be a milky-licking piece of nipple-clamp-loving, butt-plug-up-the-ass-looking, hating crap. All right? Don't do it. As a matter of fact, I'm going to go ahead and take a break here, folks. I'm going to go ahead and take a break. But before I do, I would like to go ahead and talk about this next artist that I'm about to play on the True Capitalist Radio program. This artist, believe it or not, actually brought in the Seattle movement in the early 90s. Believe it or not, my son was a big fan of this group. Such a big fan that when the lead singer died, I actually purchased a damn autographed signature from some collectible shop for this brat little son of mine, although he still has it, he still hangs it in his room, whatever. But anyway, without any further ado, let me go ahead and throw in the artists of grunge, Nirvana, Aneurysm, baby!
listening to Ghost
on True Capitalist Radio.
True Capitalist Radio.
Hey, we're back, folks. You know what time it is. We're chilling like some villains here. You know what I'm talking about? We're chilling like some villains here. Hold on. I'm looking at my damn... I'm looking at my damn cell phone. Excuse me. Anyway, folks, 646-652-4869 is the number to call. I want to hear from you folks. I'm kind of, kind of sick of talking about all the darn garbage that's happening. Rahm Emanuel is now mayor of Chicago. That just proves to me that, the American public are a bunch of morons. Now we've got the state of America in, somewhat disarray because inevitably, everybody just wants to kick back and just do nothing. That's what basically people want to do. They want to do absolutely nothing. Nothing! I mean, what makes me sick, what makes me disgustingly sick is that you got these unions sitting here trying to exploit the fact that they love the students. Oh, we love the damn students, don't we? Huh? Yeah, give me a break. They're exploiting the taxpayer. And, like I've said, and I'll continue to say, welcome to Junkyard America. Oh, yeah, folks. Welcome to Junkyard America, baby, where we got the teachers here. They're sitting here bitching and moaning. They want more money, baby. They want more. I'm just sorry, I'm reading the chat room here, man. That was a good one there, Billy D. Williams. Anyway, we got about 50 minutes left in the True Capitalist program. I want to hear from you folks. 646-652-4869. This is a special hump day edition of the True Capitalist radio show. You know how it is. Anyway, how do you think I'm supposed to feel when you got Rahm Emanuel obviously stepping down as the chief of staff from the president to distance himself from the bad decisions that were his call? You notice that? Haven't you noticed that who would actually step down as the so-called chief of staff from the White House unless you did some bad moves? You know what I'm talking about? And all of a sudden, he was just barely put on the ballot of Chicago, and all of a sudden Chicago's just going to go ahead and, we're going to let him in. What nonsense. What utter crap. Anyway, folks, 646-652-4869 is the number to call here. Do we got any callers? Let me check out the switchboard. No, we don't got any callers. We just got a bunch of milky-looking pieces of nipple-clamp-loving butt-plug-up-the-ass-looking pieces of crap. So what I'm going to do here, hold on just 1 second. Let me go ahead and do a couple of things on the computer. We're going to go ahead and call Madison, Wisconsin, and see if we can get some kind of a response. See if we can get some kind of response from the people in the area that are actually pro-public union, that are exploiting the American taxpayer. That's what we're going to do right now. All right? So everybody that's sitting there listening, you better spread the word like wildfire. All right? Let me go ahead and do that here. Let me go ahead and... Hold on just 1 second, folks. We're dialing in the number right now. We're seeing what's going on here. Hold on just 1 second.
It's
see what we got.
The number you have reached has been disconnected or is no longer in
here
service.
Here we go. Once again, the damn idiots from Madison, Wisconsin, they can't pay their bill. But they have enough time and enough energy to go out and, go out and strike for dumbass reasons. That's what they can do, huh? Oh, we got somebody here. Answer the damn phone. Oh, man, they ain't answering the phone. They just hung up, for Christ's sake. They better have some decent love-making sessions going on or something, because, good God, because how are you not going to answer the damn phone, for Christ's sake? You're just going to pick it up and hang up. We're trying another one.
The number you have reached has been disconnected.
Come on! I mean, what's going on out there in Madison, Wisconsin, for Christ's sake? Are you a bunch of poor assholes out there? Is that why you're striking and pissing and moaning and all this
the
other crap?
The number you have reached has been disconnected.
Look at that. That's what it seems like. That's what it seems like, for Christ's sake. I'm just dialing random numbers here to try to get somebody on the damn horn to see if we can get somebody here. Let me go. Let's go on. They're not even answering the damn phone. They're all out there. They're all out there, for Christ's sake. I mean, you know, give me a damn break. Here, I'm gonna try another one here. Hold on. All right. I'm just dialing random numbers. This is nobody specific here. Shut up! Let's do another one here. I'm trying here. I'm trying to call Wisconsin and see if we can get to the bottom of what's going on here.
Here right now, please leave your name and number, and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Thanks. Bye.
Hey, we want to know what the hell's going on in Madison, Wisconsin there, buddy. You know, I can tell by the, you know, fruity twang in your voice that you're probably down with these teachers, but we really don't appreciate it. And I think it's sick to my stomach that we have to sit here and pallet. We have to sit here and pallet these damn teachers going out, striking, doing all this nonsense. For what? For nothing, you asshole. For nothing. So screw Madison, Wisconsin, and screw you. Anyway, get them off. Let's do it again. All right, I'm getting somebody from Wisconsin, man. I don't care. I am, man.
Your call cannot be completed as dialed.
Well, shove it up your ass then, you slut. All right? All right, let me see what we got here. Oh, man, it's a short ring there. Maybe it's a government office.
Hello, we are unable to answer right now. To send a fax, please start transmission. To leave a voice message, please speak after the beep. Thank you.
How you doing? This is Mr. 4chan,
And we're calling up because we are in support of the teachers' unions out there. We believe that the teachers should be able to exploit the students whenever they want to. Whenever they feel like it, they can just go ahead and bus in students and just kind of have them out there in front of the Capitol protesting, even though they don't know why they're protesting, so that sort of thing. So I want to say what's up to my friend Mr. E-Bomb, but this is Mr. 4chan. Screw you pieces of crap that are sitting here flapping your little mealy-mouth gums that, you know, the unions don't deserve this, the unions don't deserve that. The unions deserve everything. Do you understand that? Excuse me, I'm a little sick here. I'm a little sick. Here, hey, we got somebody who's put the Wisconsin Teachers Union on the screen here. Let's give them a call, huh? Let's see what the hell they got to say. All right. Let's do this.
Thank you for calling the Wisconsin Education Association Council. Many of the staff are out of the building today regarding Governor Walker's budget repair bill. If this is a reporter, please press 2. All other callers, please press 0 to speak to the WEAC receptionist. Thank you.
I can't press anything right now. Beep, meep, meep.
Your call is being answered by IP Office.
WEAC Front Desk
is not available. To leave a message, wait for the tone.
Yeah, this is Ghost from True Capitalist Radio. We have over 1,000 listeners listening to us right now, and we actually want to get to the bottom of why exactly the teachers' unions and all these teachers' associations are actually exploiting taxpayers. Now, I know that you, employees of the government think that you deserve something just because, I don't know, you think you're just some special case of some sort. But what you need to realize is that you're exploiting the taxpayer. You're exploiting the taxpayer, and there are thousands of people that realize what exactly you're doing. You should be ashamed of yourself exploiting students for the sake of your salaries, for the sake of your pensions, for the sake of your pay. Look, there was an economic contraction in 2008. Okay, there was a lot of people laid off, lawyers, reporters, journalists, blue-collar workers. There was everybody that was laid off. People got foreclosed on, except for you people. You people were living in a different reality, a different world. And now that the economic contraction is affecting you, now all of a sudden you're pulling out this Karl Marx worshiping garbage out of your ass. And you should all be ashamed of yourself for using the students, for ploys, as a stranglehold on the education system. You should all be in the streets in the unemployment line where you belong. You should all be ashamed of yourselves, all of you. You know, sitting out there and acting like a bunch of communist nut jobs. You're sick. How in the hell can you sit here and talk about, oh, we deserve this, we deserve that? You deserve nothing. Anyway, this is Ghost from True Capitalist Radio. You look me up. All right, you'll find me, you stupid Wisconsin teachers union. You should be ashamed of yourselves, all of you. All of you! You piece of crap, all of you!
Maximum length recorded. To re-record, press 1. To delete, press star D. If finished, press pound.
I'm just going to hang up, all right, because I can't press anything. That's enough. Get them off. Let me tell you something, all right? Let me tell you something. I'm sick and tired of these damn teachers. I'm sick and tired of what's going on in the world. This is international disorder. And, an international disorder. We got people in the Middle East. We got people in China dying for liberty and dying for capitalism. They're dying. And meanwhile, the people in America are sitting here begging for socialism, begging for communism. I mean, what the hell's going on? What gives, for Christ's sake? What in the hell gives? I mean, it's sad to see that the country that used to be the bastion of capitalism, the bastion of the economic model, become the bastards. Because that's what we are, the bastards. Anyway, we got some more callers here. 1096, are you there?
Oh.
bastard. Anyway, Victor Rez, are you there? You see, this is America here. You see this? This is it right here. This is America right here, you know? This is it right here. This is America. It makes me disgustingly ill, but this is it. This is us! I mean, that's it right there. This is America, you know? I mean, I come here every single goddamn day of my life trying to, you know, shoot you people pearls. You know what I'm talking about? If you're listening to the True Capitalist Radio program, it's like making freaking money. But you see, that's just not good enough for, you know, some of these ass clowns that want to, you know, sit around, you know, flat their fat Cheeto-stained fingers on the keyboard, tickle their ass cracks, think it's a great day in Mr. Rogers' neighborhood, the whole goddamn 9 yards. It makes me sick! Oh, it makes me sick! So at this point in time, you know what I'm going to do, all right? You know what I'm going to do? I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to go get off. You know, it's Wednesday. I'm in Austin, Texas right now. Hold on, let me take Goku's call, and then I'm going to get off because I'm going to go down to 6th Street, and I'm going to go chug some beers. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go chug some beers, have some, have some margaritas or something then. You know, I'm going to go down to West 6th Street. Hopefully I can see Ryan Reynolds and, of course, Sandra Bullock and her black baby. You know, Sandra Bullock and her black baby. So anyway, Goku, you there, Goku?
Yeah, I'm here, Goz. What's up?
Hey, what's up, man? You still sick?
Yeah, I've still got the cold.
Yeah, it sucks, man. What's going on with you, man?
Nothing much. What's going on with you?
No, I'm just, you know, pissed off that, you know, these idiots out here are just, treating the True Capitalist Radio Show like a bunch of garbage and besmirching the integrity of this show. And I really don't appreciate it.
Well, I don't appreciate it either because I'm trying to listen to your show and I get stupid prank callers calling in.
Yeah, that's how it is. That's how these people are, for Christ's sake. You know, that's how it is. That's how it is. And, you know, I'm sitting over here and I'm trying to tell these guys. I'm trying to tell these guys how to make some freaking money, you know. And lo and behold, you know, what are they doing? They're sitting out here. They're putting, you know, large pieces of furniture up their anal passage, seeing how good that would feel, because that's the only satisfaction they're really going to get in their life, you know?
Hey, yeah. Hey,
it's disgraceful. What's up, man?
Yeah, I'll let you get going here. I don't got really much anything to say, but have fun on West 6th Street.
Yeah,
happy hour, whatever.
Right, I am. I'm going to try to see if I can find, Sandra Bullock and her black baby. So we can, maybe have a picture and, I can put it on the website or something of that nature.
Yeah, all right. Take care, Goku.
All right, Goku, man. You be cool, bro. All right? You be cool. Anyway, folks, I think I'm going to go ahead and take a step back from the broadcast here. You know, I mean, I'm a little tired, to be honest with you, folks. I've been trading futures since the beginning of the day. I woke up at 5 in the morning. When all these assholes were increasing the futures today, before the day's trading, these idiots were basically making it even more of an incentive for me to bet against the market. And because I bet against the market in early morning's futures, I made serious cake, baby. Anyway, I want to please let everybody know to add to the favorites. Ghostpolitics.blogspot.com. That's the official website of the True Capitalist Radio program. Actually, it's the official blog of the True Capitalist Radio Show. Anyway, folks, I want to thank everybody for tuning in with me. I know that we're cutting the show a little short today, but, you know, to be honest with you, folks, I mean, I got a little cash in my pocket, you know? I'm going to actually call the wife down there to meet me at one of these West 6th Street joints. Have a couple of martinis, maybe a couple of glasses of champagne, maybe buy a bottle of champagne. You know what I'm talking about? I mean, that's what it's about, diversification of your portfolio. You're going to make some serious capital. Anyway, in the next couple of shows, folks, I don't know about tomorrow, but Baller Friday. For Baller Friday, I am going to rap because there's a lot of people out here that actually want to give credibility to the whole concept of rap,
But I think rap is crap. And you can repeat that once again. Rap is crap. And I am going to bust a flow to show everybody, that rap ain't nothing. And that I can do it better than any of those other rappers out there do it. So mark it on your calendars, Baller Friday. Ghost is going to rap it. Let me tell you, if you happen to know a rapper, if you happen to know one of these ass clowns that are out here making all this money, you tell them to give me a call. I will outflow their ass. You understand what I'm saying? I am a rap battler from hell, for Christ's sake. I mean, let me tell you, I will make them look lower than a goddamn mini-me's nutsack, and there is nothing they can do, all right? I know rap is crap. Look, people are saying, hey, rap is crap. We know this. I'm just going to prove that fact. You know what I'm talking about? Anyway, folks, I want to thank everybody for tuning in with me. I'm going to get out of here. I know I'm closing out early. Tomorrow, I'm going all 3 hours. I'm just a little tired today. I've been trading futures at 5 in the morning. I've been doing a lot of things. So anyway, folks, I want to thank you for tuning in with me. Once again, I'm still paying anybody who can go out there and make a True Capitalist Radio video on YouTube and make it viral. Remember, it must be viral, 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 viral. And if you happen to have made a YouTube video, email me up. Email me with a link, ghostpolitics@yahoo.com. That's ghostpolitics@yahoo.com. Email me the link. Let me know if you made a video. Make sure it's viral. I don't want to see like, you know, 20, you know, hits on it, for Christ's sake. I want to see it viral. I want to hear you spread the word about the True Capitalist Radio program. So spread it around. Spread it around like wildfire. Spread it around, folks. Anyway, of course, the True Capitalist Radio website, blogtalkradio.com/ghost. I'm out of here. I will be here tomorrow. I'm here Monday through Friday, 4 to 7 p.m. Central Standard Time. So be here, be live, and don't be one of these people that catches me on the archive. I mean, come in. Make an effort to come on into the live broadcast. There's nothing like a live broadcast from Ghost. Anyway, I'm out of here. I'm off to happy hour on 6th Street. Hopefully I can bump into Sandra Bullock and her black baby. I'm out of here. Spread the word about the True Capitalist Radio Show, blogtalkradio.com/ghost. I'm out of here, folks.
You've been listening to True Capitalist Radio. The thoughts, views, ideas, comments, and opinions of the host of this show are absolutely his. Catch more live episodes Monday through Friday from 3:30 to 6:30 Central, or check out archive shows at blogtalkradio.com. True Capitalist Radio.
That's it.
Boar's Head is bringing a slice of Japan to the deli. Introducing Boar's Head Ichiban Teriyaki Style Chicken. Tender, slow-roasted chicken breast, coated in our signature teriyaki glaze, where ginger, garlic, and a hint of brown sugar meet for a flavor that's both sweet and savory. New Boar's Head Ichiban Teriyaki Style Chicken. The bold flavor of Japan. Now at the deli. Only from Boar's Head. Compromise elsewhere.